Blackstone Publishing presents 30,000 on the Hoof by Zane Gray. This book is read by Robert G. Slade.
Chapter 1. General Crook and his regiment of the Western Division of the U.S. Army were cutting a road through the timber on the rim of the Mogollon Mesa above the Tonto Basin. They had as captives a number of Apache Indians, brave squaws and children, whom they were taking to be placed under guard on the reservation. At sunset, they made camp at the head of one of the canyons, running away from the rim. It was a park-like oval, a little way down from the edge, rich with silver grass and watered by a crystal brook that wound under the giant pines. The noisy advent of the soldiers and their horses and pack mules disturbed a troop of deer that trotted down the canyon to stop and look back, long ears erect. Crook's campaign was about over, and the soldiers were jubilant. They joked with the somber-eyed Apaches who sat huddled in a group under guard. Packs and saddles plopped to the grass, the ring of axes echoed through the forest, blue smoke curled up into sunset-flushed pines. The general, never a stickler for customs of the service, sat with his captain and a sergeant, resting after the hard day and waiting for supper.
"Wonder how old Geronimo's gonna take this," mused Crook.
"Well, we haven't heard the last of that redskin," replied Willis emphatically. "He'll break out sooner or later, and then there'll be hell to pay."
"I'm glad we didn't have to kill any of these Apaches."
"Well, we were lucky, General. I bet McKinney'll burn powder before he stops that Matazal and his braves. Bad youngsters."
"Do you know Matazal, Sergeant?" inquired Crook.
"I seen him. Strapping young buck. Only Indian I ever saw with gray eyes. He's said to be one of Geronimo's sons."
"Well, McKinney won't stand any monkey business from that outfit," added Willis. "He's collared him by this time. Huett knows the country. He'll track him to some hole in the woods."
"Good scout, Logan Huett, for so young a man. He has been invaluable in this campaign. I shall recommend him to my successor."
"Huett is through with Army Scout Service after this campaign. He'll be missed if old Geronimo breaks out and goes on the warpath. Fine woodsman. Best rifle shot I ever saw."
"What is Huett going to do?"
"Told me he wanted to go home to Missouri for a while. He's got a girl, I reckon, but he's hipped on the West and will soon be back."
"He surely will," added the other officer. "Logan Huett was cut out for a pioneer. The West needs such men more than the Army. Hello, I hear shouts from above."
"Bet that's McKinney now," said Willis, rising.
"Sure enough, I see horses in army blue through the trees," added the sergeant.
Presently, a squad of soldiers rode down into the glade. They had three mounted Indians with them, and another on foot, a tall, lithe brave, straight as an arrow, whose bearing was proud. These captives were herded with the others. Sergeant McKinney reported to General Crook that he had secured Matazal and three of his companions. The others got away on foot.
"Any shooting?" queried the general.
Yes, sir. We couldn't surprise them, and they showed fight. We have two men wounded, not serious."
"I hope you didn't kill any Indians."
We didn't, to our knowledge."
"Send Huett to me."
The scout approached. He was a young man, about 23 years old, dark of face. In fact, he bore somewhat of a resemblance to Matazal, and he was so stalwart and powerfully built that he did not look tall.
"What's your report, Huett?"
"General, we made sure of getting Matazal alive," replied the scout. "Otherwise, none of them would have escaped. I guessed where Matazal's bunch was headed for. We cut in behind them, chased them into a box canyon, where we cornered them. They had but little ammunition, or we'd had a different story to tell."
"Don't dodge the main point as McKinney did. Were there any Indians killed?"
"We couldn't find any dead ones."
"Willis, fetch this Apache to me."
In a few moments, Matazal stood before the general, his arms crossed over.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.